Hello, in this lesson we're going to apply Kirchhoff's rules in a circuit. Before you watch this video, I advise you to watch our previous videos on Kirchhoff's rules. Alright, so let's go apply Kirchhoff's rule step by step in a circuit, okay? Here's the circuit we have, and we want to find the current flowing in each part of the circuit, okay? So we already know the tensions here, the resistances, okay? These small R's are the internal resistances, and the other ones. And we want to find I1, I2, and I3, alright? Let's start then with Kirchhoff's first rule. It's the junction rule, okay? We're going to apply it at this point here, point A. So I already labeled the currents, okay, I1, I2, and I3. So applying the junction rule, we can say that I1 is I2 plus I3, okay? And that's our first equation that we have, okay? Let's now apply the second rule, the loop rule, in this first loop here, okay, A, B, C, D, E, A, in this direction, all right, clockwise. So if we apply the loop rule here, we have that EMF 1 minus I2 R2 minus I2 times small R1 minus I1 times R1, okay? This needs to be zero, okay? In this loop here, this tension losses needs to be zero when you end the loop, all right? So we can add these two R's together and put the values here. Then we have our equation number 2. Alright, let's keep going now and apply the loop rule in this other loop, okay? The loop is A, H, G, F, E, A, alright? I know that the natural flow for the current would be this one, right? As I put the arrows here, but let's take the other direction here, because I want to show you that it actually doesn't matter the direction you take, okay? You get the same result. So let's go. We can say then for loop number 2, we have I3, R2, the small r here, plus I3, R3, plus I1, R1. For this resistance, minus the EMF 2 equals 0, okay? This sign here is because I'm taking the loop clockwise also, alright, against this flow here, alright? So again, you can add these two R's and insert the values, and we get equation number 3. And now we have three equations and three variables, I1, I2, and I3. So we can solve to find the currents. Good. So let's start using equation number 2. Okay. From equation number 2, we can isolate I2 in respect to I1. Okay. We can do the same for equation number 3, but isolating I3. So we have the relation for I2 and I3 in respect to I1. Then we can go to equation number 1 and find that I1 is actually 4.75 amperes. Now that we have I1, we can go back here in equation number 2, right, to find I2, negative 3.5 amperes, and in equation number 3 to find I3 equals 8.25 amperes. So see that I1 and I3 are positive, right? So it means it is in the correct direction, all right? However, you can see here that I2 is actually negative. So it means it's flowing in the opposite direction that I assumed before, okay? So that's the thing. It doesn't matter the direction you assume the current to be flowing, you get this the right result. And when you see a negative here, well, you don't have negative current, so it means it's flowing in the opposite way, okay? So that's it. Hope you enjoy it and see you next time.
Now that you watched this video, you're one step closer to achieving your academic goals. Well done! There's always more to learn, so check out our other videos and don't forget to subscribe.